Hi, and welcome to another MI How To video. My name is Tom Clark. I am your host, and on today's How To, we're going to talk about how to properly add or replace lubricant in the popular Boston Gear 700 Series single reduction gearboxes. And joining us is Greg Kober. He is the training manager for Altra Industrial Motion brands, including Boston Gear. Greg, thanks so much for joining us.
Oh, thanks for having me.
You know, Greg, I'm glad we've got an opportunity to talk about this important topic, since enclosed gearboxes require the correct lubrication in the correct amount to operate properly, because if I'm not mistaken, it's those two factors that are the most common cause of premature failure in worm gearboxes, right?
That's right, Tom. Decades of experience tell us that incorrect lubrication levels or the use of incorrect lubrication are the top causes of gearbox failure. These often damaging, unexpected failures can significantly impact a facility's productivity and profitability. We should note that over-lubrication can be as damaging as under-lubrication. Too much lube can lead to leaks or seal damage.
To get started, what we have on the table for a tool, we got a 5/16 inch Allen wrench. We have the right angle pipe fitting, and we do have some oil here as well. And just as a reminder before we begin, we always want to think safety. You should always wear the appropriate PPE protection, like glasses and gloves, maybe if you're working on something like this. And also, if you're working on a gearbox that's installed, be sure to shut down the drive safely. Observe all lockout, tagout procedures. Whatever the PPE calls for at your job, make sure it's the right stuff. All right, Greg, I'm going to let you take over from here. Okay.
Boston Gear 700 Series models have four lube port locations positioned on different sides of the unit. These ports indicate a fill, a drain, and a level hole for all mounting positions. This blue plug is the vent plug. The vent plug is shipped with new units in a plastic bag along with a manual. The purpose of the vent plug is to relieve any damaging pressure built up inside the gearbox directly into the atmosphere. It should always be positioned near the top of the unit. Alternate venting includes the Boston Gear exclusive posi vent or a 5 PSI vent. If the vent port is left open, there's no lubrication in the gearbox.
So, what can you tell us now about the types of lubrication that should be used? Because that's important as well.
Based on extensive load testing, Boston Gear recommends a Klubersynth UH1 6460 lubricant for continuous operating conditions. All our catalog ratings are based on this lube. However, some customers have identified other lubricants for use in their facilities, and that's all right. Mm-hmm. Unfortunately, these alternative lubes will decrease the catalog ratings and reduce gearbox efficiency. There's also some lubricants that are strictly not recommended, specifically those with EP additives.
Yeah, and it's important to note that different types of lubricants should never be mixed either, like right. The Klubersmith UH1 6460. Now, that's a PAG type lube, right. And mixing a PAG lube with a PAO type lube, such as Mobil SHC 634, now that's going to impact the gearbox performance significantly. All right, Greg, we've covered lubrication types, so what do you say we walk through the steps involved with actually adding lube to the 700 series gearbox?
We'll start off the process with a new unit that's not been lubricated.
Okay.
The amount of lubrication needed for a particular unit is determined by two factors, unit size and unit mounting position. You can determine unit size by finding the part number on the label on the unit.
Okay.
Or by measuring the center distance from the input shaft to the output shaft, and then referencing the catalog. For example, chart shows that a 1 3/4 inch center distance means a unit is a size 718. Next, orient the gearbox in the same position it would be used in the application, and then identify the ports that need to be plugged or open for oil fill and level locations. And then remove the plugs as needed using the Allen wrench.
Yeah, and just a cautionary note, if your gearbox has the red posivet installed, you don't want to remove it. Leave it in the existing hole location for all mounting positions.
That's right. It's important to remember that 700 series are not symmetrical internally. Therefore, if the gearbox is mounted in mounting position 1, called worm over, a different lubrication amount will be needed than if it is in mounting position 3, worm under. So, to determine how much lubricant you'll need for your particular gearbox, use the chart in the catalog. Mm-hmm. It indicates how much lube is required for each unit size and mounting position. As you'll see, these amounts can vary substantially. For a size 718 gearbox mounted in position 1, will require 12 ounces of lube. In mounting 3, it would require 18. Ideally, the target lubrication level for the gearbox is when the lube reaches the middle of the output bearing and gear. Fortunately, the port located on the backside of the gearbox is also the midpoint of the output bearing and gear. So when the gearbox will be mounted in mounting position one, the worm over, filling the lube from the upper port until it reaches that level port will indicate that oil level is correct. When mounted in position three, the lube will be filled from a different port location. However, the level port will remain the same. For maximizing the life of a new gearbox, synthetic lubricant should be changed after the first 1,500 hours of use and every 5,000 hours thereafter.
Okay.
If you're using a non-synthetic lube, consult with your lubricant supplier for interval change recommendations. Using the best lubricant, keeping it clean, will also maximize the life and the performance of your gearbox. Dirty oil will reduce gearbox efficiency and accelerate seal wear.
Thank you, Greg. Good information there. Greg Kober, he is the training manager for Altra. And if you have any questions about anything you saw here today, you can contact your nearest Motion Industries branch location, and they'll be able to help you out. As mentioned earlier, we were talking about PPE. In this case, glasses, maybe gloves, but remember, you should always think about whatever the job calls for you. Safety is priority number one. Number two, head to mihow2.com and check out more videos with me, Tom Clark, as your host. Thanks so much for watching.